there's been a growing awareness of the problems caused by the quantities of litter in the oceans. I mean, we've known about the larger items of litter, plastic bottles, crisp packets, single-use packaging items, and some of the negative effects that they could have on wildlife, and we've been working on some of those things. But I think the realization now is, of course, that, you know, even if we could wave a magic wand tomorrow and we could stop all of the imports of plastic debris to the oceans tomorrow, of course, would be wonderful, we would still see an increase in the quantity of microplastics over the next few decades. The work that we did, published in 2004, showed that there were now fragments of plastic in the ocean. We called them microplastics, smaller than the diameter of a human hair, and we showed that they could be eaten by marine organisms with a range of different feeding strategies: filter feeders, detritivores that would normally eat natural organic material at the top of the beach, and creatures that lived in and amongst the marine sediments themselves. And what seems to have become even clearer since then is that that's not just theoretical, it's happening in natural populations. About 10% of all of the reported encounters between marine debris and wildlife are now with these microplastic fragments, and that includes encounters with very small creatures, small invertebrates at the base of the food chain, right the way up to larger vertebrates. Some of the work we've done here in fish from the English Channel has shown that a wide range of individuals from 10 different species are contaminated with microplastics. Scientific research is absolutely fundamental to informing policymakers and informing industry about what's the scale of the problem and what's the appropriate action that needs to be taken. And you need to understand, of course, what the quantities are, what the distribution of that plastic is, what are the creatures that might be affected, or what are the ecosystem processes that might be affected. That's a really, really important, critical scientific evidence base. I think we have to couple that evidence, scientific evidence of harm in the environment, with scientific evidence about, well, what are the alternatives? Is this essential? Is it unavoidable, shall I say, that we have this contamination in the oceans? And also the social science about what can we do to nudge behaviours in a direction to achieve the changes that we might look for to reduce the quantities, the accumulation of plastic in the environment. Because to me, that's one of the key things about this particular environmental challenge. To my mind, it's completely avoidable. Very clear that plastics can bring many societal benefits, but in most cases, those benefits can be realized without the need for the accumulation of litter in the environment, if there's been an appropriate consideration, I would argue, at the design stage.